Hello, Helen here. Thanks for joining me for another card in my Christmas card series for 2017. This one's just a little bit more complicated, but when you do it in the steps, it breaks it down to be quite easy. I'm going to start off by doing the background. I'm going to do some foiling with a stencil. I'm starting with a card panel that's 14.5 by 14.5 centimetres, and I'm going to stick it down on my mat with some painter's tape just so that it doesn't move. I'm going to be using the Simon Says stamp stencil called Falling Snow, and I'm going to stick that down with some painter's tape on top. I'm going to be doing the stenciling with this new product that I've just bought called Deco Transfer Gel. Now, it's opened a whole new world in foiling for me. I really enjoy foiling, and it's always been very limiting, but this means that you can use any of the stencils you've got to do foiling. It's a lovely creamy consistency paste, and you just spread it on with a palette knife, but like you would texture paste. Although it's smoother than that. So just smooth a very thin coat on and smoothen it out, and then you can put what's you scrape back off back into the pot, and I'm just going to put that aside then to dry once I've peeled the stencil off. You need to make sure that you wash your stencil and palette knife straight away, because it does end up going quite hard and you've ruined your stencil, so just go away and wash it straight away. This is my first attempt at this card, and for the bauble I ended up using craft foam between each of the layers of the background, and I decided it was really too thick for posting, so I'm going to do a modified version of this card and show you that today. I'm using this bezel card called Blue Calypso, a lovely teal colour. I thought it matched quite nicely with the mink teal foil that I'm going to use for my background. I'm going to use this deer scene dye that I've got to make the bauble, so I'm just going to cut that out of white. You could really use any scene that you've got, a nice winter cottage or a tree lined border dye. Any of those kind of wintry scenes would be perfect for this. The next piece of essential equipment is a circle die set. Mine's a stitched circle die, but it doesn't have to be. And just whatever set you've got, you'll need four consecutive dies. So I'm taking the second or third one in and then working four down from that. To do the most outside part of the bauble, I've got the first two biggest dies, and I'm going to stick them together so that they make a tiny thin frame, and then I'm going to cut white card with that. And while I've got those two dies stuck together, I'll cut out a frame with craft foam as well, and then I'll separate them and do the next circle. The next thing I'm going to do is take those apart and use the biggest frame and the next one down from the one I've just used, so that'll be the third smaller frame. And I'm going to stick those together with some washi tape to make a frame and cut that out in the teal card. The next frame I'm cutting out is the largest one and the smallest of the four frames, and again I'm sticking those together and cutting them out. And lastly, I'm cutting out one teal circle with the largest of the dies only, and that's going to make the back. You'll see that I've got consecutive frames getting smaller and smaller, which just gives slight tunnel dimensional look. With my first card that I made, I ended up doing a more ombre effect with the three circles and then did a foil background, but either way is fine. I just thought I'd make this one a little bit simpler. The next thing to do is to glue the back circle and the two frames together on top of each other, just so that they go down in size. I'll just use some liquid glue for that. And then I can start looking at the bauble frame, the white frame, and working out whereabouts I'm going to cut the deer scene down just to fit inside that bauble. So I'll glue the parts of the white frame and stick that down onto where I want the scene to be, and then I'll trim the deer scene away from around the outside edge of that. I can then glue the craft foam frame onto the back of that and then glue that onto my teal circles, and that's the bauble finish. So I'm just going to put that aside and press something onto heavy onto it just so it all dries, and then I can get on with doing the foiling. Now I've got the stencil that has been drying all this time. I don't know whether you can see it in the camera, but it's gone quite shiny but perfectly dry. That's the stage that it's supposed to be at for foiling. So I'm just going to get a piece of teal foil that's a bit bigger than the stencil size, and then put that with the colour face up into a carrier sheet and put it through my mink machine that has been warming up. now the big reveal. Wow, look at that. I love the foil effect. The camera just doesn't do it justice. I'm now going to trim that panel down so that it's about a centimetre smaller than my card base. I do a card base that's 14.5 centimetres square, which is just shy of a 6-inch square card. So I'm going to trim that with a craft knife on a craft mat. Lining it up on the craft mat where the squares are, and I'm just cutting one square's worth off all the way around the card. Nice and easy. Before I stick the card panel down onto the card, I'm going to just get a piece of ribbon that's going to go behind the bauble, up and over the top of the card edge and down the back, just to secure it. So I'm going to put some double-sided tape on a piece of ribbon and then put it into position, and then I'm going to put some craft foam onto the back of that panel and then stick that onto my card base. Then I can go ahead and stick the bauble down on over the ribbon that I've just popped on the card panel, and I'm ready just to tie a bow with my bow maker. It's a very simple piece of equipment. It's just really a block of wood that's had some holes drilled into it that dowel pieces fit into. I've got two shorter ones and two longer ones, depending on what width of ribbon I'm using, and it's just a matter of moving the dowels closer together if you want a small bow, or further apart if you want a big bow. It works for me. I'm usually quite happy with the bows that I make with it, so it's just a matter of wrapping the ribbon around once or twice, depending on whether you want a single or double bow, and then you can take the fabric round the back, which ends up being the front of your bow. Pull it to the front, tie a knot, and then slip it off the dowels, and there's your bow. Thank you. I'm going to stick the bow on with the glue dot. I could do glue and weight it down, but it's just faster with a glue dot. And then that's the card finished. You can see the difference here between the amount of dimension in the pink one compared to the teal one. The pink one's nice having the ombre effect, which you definitely see better if you've got the foam between it, but it wouldn't be so good for posting, where the teal one would be much better for that. So thanks very much for watching today. I'll see you next time with another video. Please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. Bye for now.